So I have a sound file from which I want to extract intensity of stop consonants, namely of P, T, K, B, D, and G. And I would also like to get the intensity of S, which I will compare to that of the stop consonants. So to do that, I will first need to break this sound file that I have into smaller segments, each containing one of the consonants between two vowels. Then I will be able to annotate each of the smaller sound files by labeling the consonant and the following vowel and compare the intensity thereof. So here in a folder called AD1, I have the sound file that I will use along with some other files that I will use later. So let's open this sound file in Praat. I launch Praat and I click Open. And because the sound file is quite large, I will open it as a long sound file. So I click Open Long Sound File. Frogstory.wav, and I click Open. And then I click View to view it. So here you can see the waveform of the sound file. I can use these buttons in the bottom left corner of the window to zoom in or out. I can also zoom in by pressing Command-I on Mac or Control-I on Windows. And similarly, I can zoom out by pressing Command-O or Control-O. I can also select a part of the file with my mouse and zoom in on that segment by pressing Command-N or Control-N. And if I zoom in close enough, I can also see the spectrogram. And to make sure that Praat runs as fast as possible on your computer, you might want to disable pitch, which is this blue line, formants, which are these red dots, and the intensity, which is the yellow line. So to do that, I click pitch and uncheck show pitch, formant and uncheck show formants. And I can also click here and uncheck show intensity. But I will leave it checked because the intensity line will help me to find the stop consonants that I'm looking for. If you are using a Mac with a trackpad, you can pinch to zoom in or out, and you can swipe with two fingers to scroll left or right. Or instead, you can just use the scroll bar on the bottom of the window. I can play the visible part of the file by clicking here on the bottom.
Y nada, está el niño tan feliz con su rana y el perro muy sorprendido.
I can also select the part of the file and play the selection by pressing tab on my keyboard.
El niño tan feliz.
Let's zoom out to see the whole file by pressing Command A or Control A on Windows. As you can see, the waveform is not visible because the window is longer than 60 seconds. Anyway, I need to find words with consonants P, T, K, B, D, G, and S between two vowels, so let's find three such words. I know there's a word with a P somewhere around here. And let's listen to this selection. And there you have it, the consonant P in the word pues. I can save this selection by clicking File, save selected sound as WAV file, and I will create a folder where I will put all the segments, and I'll call that folder Segments, and I will name the file P underscore, because P is the consonant in my segment, Inieta Pues, because that's what the speaker is saying, and .wav. And make sure not to use any diacritics such as accent marks or tildes in your file names, otherwise you might run into problems later. And I click Save to save the segment. Now let's find a word with a G in between two vowels, and I think there happens to be such a word right before the one we just found. And let's listen to this segment.
Y en la siguiente.
And I think the word is this one.
Siguiente. Siguiente.
And that is the word siguiente. So let's save the selection, file, save selected sound as WAV file, and let's call it G underscore siguiente dot WAV, and let's click save. Let's find a word with an S, and I believe there's one somewhere around here, and let's check.
Básicamente. Básicamente. Básicamente.
So the word básicamente has an S in between two vowels, and let's save this segment, file, save selected sound as wave file, S underscore básicamente dot WAV, and notice how I did not include the accent mark on the first A, even though the word básicamente is spelled with one. Save. So that's how you can select parts of a sound file with consonants between two vowels and save them as a wave file.